Hey everybody, dutchsinse here. 1:44 p.m. Central Time on Sunday, November 17th, 2013. And I've got you over here on Earthquake 3D, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes, and you can see a 3.2 magnitude earthquake up here in the Pacific Northwest in Washington State. And whenever we see activity up here in the Pacific Northwest, normally I try to check it, see what's going on, whether it's at a volcano or it's going to be at another location. They do have some oil pumping going on up there as well. So I decided to go check this earthquake, and what's at the epicenter is very interesting. So let's go ahead and look this up. And these are the coordinates from the USGS. Notice they don't really tell you kind of what's there. All right, it's up to you guys to go look this stuff up and see what's there. So we'll paste these in and we'll hit search. Now I've already marked where the earthquake is, and I'm bringing it back in just so you guys can see where it is in relation to the rest of the country. And we'll just wait for it to zoom in here. Okay, so here it is. Now let me just back this out just a little bit here. And you guys are gonna see a couple things. We've got the Fast Flux Test Facility. We also have the Gravity Wave Sensor Station, LIGO, and the start of the Hanford Nuclear Waste Disposal Facility. Plutonium, uranium, you can click on some of these. See this? It's National Geographic. It says dangerous debris. And I'll just read the top paragraph here to you. Bristling with weapons and tactical gear, a guard stands ready to defend steel and concrete casks holding spent fuel from a reactor in eastern Washington. Now, what's here is a huge complex, not just one, but we're talking old reactors, multiple experimental reactors that were built over many years across this entire area. Since then, they built the Gravity Wave Sensor Station, which is just weird. This is something that we all need to look into, the gravity wave. The fact that they would put this next to a nuclear storage facility where they have some very heavy elements makes you wonder. And then you've got these hills here, and over here it's literally called Gravity Hill. There it is right there. There's YouTube videos where people will put their car into neutral and it'll go uphill. Those are interesting to watch. Here's Gravity Hill. That pre-exists the Gravity Wave Station at LIGO. That's been there for a very long time. You can look up the local legends on this. Also, up here, here's all the different reactors. C reactor, B reactor, all the different experimental reactors, K reactor. And they store all that spent fuel there. And then right next to here, you've got a fast flux test facility. And let's just read this. The FFTF is a sodium-cooled 400 megawatt fast flux test reactor that has been shut down and defueled. About 75% of the plant systems are still operating. The cleanup system, the effluent monitoring system, primary and secondary cooling pumps, air handling units, nitrogen inserting of cells, argon process. These processes will all terminate and be transitioned to D&D, whatever that is, when the reactor plant is deactivated. About 75 metric tons of irradiated mixed oxide reactor fuel, as well as 320,000 gallons of radioactive liquid sodium are stored there. That's what that is. Okay, you guys can go read the rest on this. I don't have time to sit here and read each description on each reactor. And of course, LIGO itself, you can see each one of these is a very long antenna that goes at least, well, at least a mile in each direction. So to have earthquakes there, not too good, next to the largest nuclear storage facility in the United States, a Superfund site. Cheers, folks. Much love.